And a very good evening to you all from Education City Stadium in Al Rayyan for this Group F match between Saudi Arabia and Thailand at the AFC Asian Cup 2023. Both teams are guaranteed a place in the round of 16, but top spots still at stake. And the positioning of the qualified teams tonight will give us our final lineup in the first of the knockout stages. And from the earlier games today, we know that the winner of this group will play the Korean Republic in the round of 16 here at Education City on the 30th of January. Temperatures 25 degrees as night falls upon the Qatari capital. Ideal for football at this wonderful venue, which of course was one of the stadiums that was used for the FIFA World Cup, which took place here in 2022. And the crowd tonight expected to predominantly favour Saudi Arabia, of course, just across the border from Qatar. And the Green Falcons are one of Asia's traditional heavyweights. They've won this tournament on three previous occasions, but not since 1996. And even though they have won both of their matches here in Qatar, they've yet to really hit top gear, leading to some criticism of their new coach, Roberto Mancini, back in Saudi Arabia. However, they are chasing a little bit of history tonight. Never before have they completed a clean sweep of group victories despite all those previous successes. And they are warm favourites to make it 3 from 3 this evening. Thailand's place in the knockout stage was confirmed by Japan's win over Indonesia yesterday. And it's consecutive Asian Cups where they've reached the last 16. And it was all made possible by that backs-to-the-wall effort against Oman, where they succeeded in keeping back-to-back clean sheets in this tournament for the very first time. Can Thailand be a little more expansive tonight? Their coach, Matasada Ishii, who, like Roberto Mancini, has had limited time in charge to prepare for this tournament, was realistic yesterday, admitting it might well be a similar type of performance to the one we saw against Oman. Two nations have met on 18 previous occasions. The Saudis have won 14, the Thais just 3, with the other match having been drawn. But the War Elephants have not beaten the Green Falcons in 40 years. 1984, their last win in a friendly in Jeddah. And since then, the Saudis have won 13 of the 14 fixtures. Saudi Arabia know this stadium well. They played at the World Cup in 2022 here against Poland. They were not successful on that occasion, losing by 2-0. And this venue is not quite done after this game with the AFC Asian Cup. It will host one of the round of 16 ties and one of the quarterfinals as well. These two will be in the round of 16, but who is going to top Group F? We're about to find out. It's Saudi Arabia against Thailand.
Oh,
Well, there's not too many Thai fans here. They're going to have to shout loud to make themselves heard. And in terms of the team news, wholesale changes for both sides. Saudi Arabia making 9 in total. Only captain Salem Al-Dosri and defender Ali Al-Bulehi survived from the win over Oman. Goalkeeper Raged Naja makes his international debut. The defence, Al-Bulehi aside, has just 9 caps between them. Mukhtar Ali, the former Chelsea junior, comes into midfield. And the Kyrgyz Republic, and those top three spots are up for grabs. If Saudi win or draw, they will win the section. Thailand need to get all 3 points to finish in first spot, and Oman could yet clinch a place in the round of 16. So it's Saudi Arabia in all green and Thailand in predominantly all white as we count down to kickoff. And the group stage entering its final couple of hours. It's been thrilling. There's been some great goals and some shocks. Might we see another one here tonight, Andy Harper?
Yeah, good evening, Simon. Well, of course, it's very possible. Malaysia, I think, have shown what could be possible when nothing really expected. A tremendous performance for them against the Korea Republic. Thailand would need to improve a lot on their first two outings to beat Saudi, even with all the changes. But they have top spot still in their sights if they've got an appetite for it. And across town has Oman played Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan could finish on 3 points. And if they knock in quite a few goals in doing so, I know I'm delving well into the world of the improbable here, but that might get people thinking as well.
This is Patompon for Thailand, and he's earned the game's first corner. Challenge from Fawaz Al-Yami.
Be interesting to see tonight with the approach of the Thai team. In the Oman game, they were extraordinarily conservative, knowing that a draw would get them through to the round of 16, and they set up and played just to contain Oman. I wonder now if Coach Ishii will revert to a more expansive type performance to see what sort of level his squad can hit.
Jakapan and Supan have made their way up to the corner, which doesn't really get past first base. And steered all the way back by Jeroen Sack to debutant goalkeeper Sarunov. Did wonder whether Masatata Ishii might have gone with the more experienced Siwarak, but he's opted to go with youth over experience between the posts. No doubt that Patty Watts is his number one. He's had a good tournament. It's a rather risky ball, and it needed that swift intervention from Mukhtar Ali. And Thailand have made the better start against this reworked Saudi Arabian team, who've had their critics at this AFC Asian Cup.
Well, even before coming into it, Bruno Mancini had really ruffled a lot of feathers with his comments about some of the senior statesmen in the squad, picking and choosing, in his words, when they were available for the team.
Here's a big chance for Thailand, and it needed that intervention from On Al-Saluli. And it's going to be another corner for the War Elephants.
Lobby start from Saudi.
Waricic, you can't be offside from a throw, of course. Sneaking in completely out of the awareness and sight of those Saudi defenders. And another corner for the Thais. They work it back to Jeroen Sack, who look to hit the back post where Supan was stationed. Up but not away by Al-Balehi. Saudi Arabia just can't clear their lines here. Al-Salali gets a little bit more distance, and now Salem Al-Dosri, but quickly won back for Thailand by Supanan on the right. An aggressive start by Masatata Ishii's side. Now Saudi Arabia can look to break. It's Faisal Al-Ghamdi on the charge. Top of the box is Salem Al-Dosri. Well, we know what a clever player he can be, the 2022 AFC Asian Footballer of the Year. And it was a clever idea, maybe not one that was read by his teammate.
An excellent raid upfield as well. Faisal Al-Ghamdi really bursting down the left-hand side of the field. Handing the ball off. Al-Dosri looking to thread that last pass in behind the square. Thai defence into the penalty area. Just not enough space really to work that option. A good attack from Saudi after pretty sloppy defensively to start the game.
Karman aware of possibilities on the left. Picked up here by Patompong for Thailand. By Santipat, back to the skipper for the night, Sarach Yuyen, winning his 78th cap for his country. Back with Sarunov. We did question whether Thailand would be a little bit more expansive. They've certainly been so in the first 5 minutes.
They've shown more aggression actually to start this game than they did pretty much for the entirety of the Oman game.
Pressure's off, of course. 4 points gained and qualification assured. The question is, does anybody want to win this group with Republic of Korea or Korean Republic waiting in the round of 16 for first place finisher in Group F?
Well, the closeness of some of these third group games has got everyone talking out of the side of their mouth.
Uzbekistan awaiting the runners-up, which at the moment are Thailand, but that could all change. Here's Sarach Yuyen. Well protected by Jeroen Sack. For Supanan, it's not a bad ball in, and it's going to be another corner as it skims off the head of Abdullah Al-Haybari. They do not look comfortable at all, this new look Green Falcons defensive line Roberto Mancini already deep in discussion, I assume, with the translator to try and get some messages across to his troops on the field. Thailand's third corner, and we're not even past the 7 minute mark. And headed over the top by Jakapan. Or rather, Tirasak, I should say.
Yeah, in the end, it just came onto him a bit quickly, but he had a lot of room, really. They flowed nicely going forward, and they did, Saudi, but very, very soft defensively at the moment.
Al-Balehi to Mukhtar Ali. Body. Saluli. Al-Balehi again. Looking for that run of Salim Al-Dosari, but Thailand got cut off it. Al-Dosari has stolen it on the blind side. It's really good goalkeeping. And not one but two appeals for a penalty by the Saudis. Al-Dosari was quickly up. Abdurrahman Harib stays down, and you can hear the whistles around the stadium. The Green Falcons fans felt that their player was bundled over inside the box. VAR will check it, of course. For now, we go on.
Well, in the first instance, Saranam was clean as a whistle on that challenge on Salim Al-Dosari. Ref stopped because of the concerns over a fallen player. Yet to be informed by VAR that he needs to come and have a look at something. This is excellent work. Really clean as a whistle, that goalkeeping. That looked pretty okay to me too. Excellent work, keeper. Youngster off the bench, has watched two games, has to get it millimeter perfect, and does so. Saranon.
Oh, but does Supan Tongsong upend Karib, you know.
Takes the player first.
It looks as though Saudi Arabia have got a case for a penalty. And I can tell you that they've already got the ball on the spot in anticipation. They're convinced. Abdullah Radif has grabbed the ball and is waiting for the verdict of VAR. But that angle maybe not quite so conclusive, but the one that we saw some moments ago looks clear cut. Referee Kim Hee-gon told to come across to the screen just to confirm what we think we've seen.
Yeah. Well, they've looked flowing on two attacks now. They haven't defended that well, but they look like they've got the early break in this one.
Yeah, I don't think there's much doubt about it.
Tongsong has earnestly taken the player out there to try and shield him away from the ball, but his timing is wrong, where just before his goalkeeper, Salmon's timing was absolutely perfect.
Well, Thailand are yet to concede at this AFC Asian Cup, but I fancy, and I don't really know why they're looking at it over and over again, it looks plain to see that he's not taken the ball, he's taken the player. Yeah, there we go, penalty. And all that after Thailand have made such a positive start to this game. They're now reliant on their debutant goalkeeper, Saranon, to keep out what looks like it's going to be Abdullah Radif's penalty. This young man, 21 years of age, plays for Al-Shabaab. He's won golden boots in both the Saudi under-17 and under-19 leagues before graduating to the first team at Al-Hilal. He's now currently on loan with Al-Shabaab. In fact, looks like Salim Al-Dosari has pulled rank. Having a bit of a discussion here. No, it is going to be Abdullah Radif. I thought for a moment Al Dosri had said no.
Well, it's a popular choice.
Yeah.
Whatever's taken place.
Is it popular with the coach? Whether he scores or not will determine that. Saved by the goalkeeper. Abdulradif denied by Saranon. What a moment for the goalkeeper on debut. And maybe Salem Al Dosri should have taken the spot kick.
Well, maybe. But this is the moment for Saranon. And his first intervention as Salem, the Saudi skipper, was bearing down on goal was excellent. His first contribution to the Asian Cup was to deny a great chance. His second is to save a penalty. What an amazing start by Saranon in the Thailand goal.
And a let-off for Supan Tongsong, who committed the foul in the first place. But the Saudis are energised after that rather sluggish start. Here's Salem Al Dosri leading the charge, the captain, weaving his way through the Thai defence. Back through Mukhtar Ali. Al Dosri again looking for the angle run of Fawaz Al-Yami in the back post. And the flag is up against the wing back. Well, what a start, Andy.
Yeah, well, sloppy defending from Saudi. They're looking good with the ball, however. They play some really nice stuff. And their first two games, the press back at home. That's a really tight one for offside, by the way, but no goal came on the back of it, so it's the assistant's call in live play, which counts, and more power to it. But despite the really negative press around the team's performances, their attacking stats have been pretty impressive.
Jakipan with foul going through the back of Abdullah Radif.
As much as Roberto Mancini might have ruffled some feathers, as much as there may be some talking behind the back of hands and corridor meetings going on, and they've passed the ball really efficiently.
And there might have been a foul there, but advantage play, and it's Fawaz Al-Yami looking to pick out a teammate. Well defended in the end. Supanam with the first intervention, and then the clearance from Santi Park. All of a sudden, Saudi Arabia have found their groove. This is Ali Al-Balehi, and he's lost out in midfield. And Sadat Yuyen will set Jaron Sack away down the right, and the cross is steered in, but the flag's gone up. It was a great header from Tirasak, but those celebrations are going to be cut short as well.
Well, again, in the booth, they'll be having a quick look, but to the naked eye, it looked like he did break that line. It was a lovely header, great steal in midfield. Tirasak.
Yeah.
Is he in front of the ball?
Just in front, I think.
Again, this is probably going to end up closer than it first looks. Wonderful header. Great breakaway from Thailand. They're up. They've already played better in 15 minutes, I think, than they did for 90 against Oman.
Well, it's difficult to remember a shot on goal that they had against Oman, but they've had a couple here already.
Continuing the theme of exciting third group match action. Very, very tense games to round out the group stage.
Yep, that's an on-field decision confirmed. The linesman was correct. And Tirasak's goal will not count. Would have been his first at international level as well. He's having to play second fiddle for the national team to Super Chai, who, of course, got both goals on match day one against the Kyrgyz Republic. Here come the Saudis, and Salem Al Dosri is finding space with ease. Little layoff and the cross. Surely, yes, this time Abdulradif makes up for the missed penalty, but the flag is up again against the Saudi Arabia striker. Goodness me.
Well, I think first place in the group actually means something to both teams. CA is clearly in front of the ball and the defenders. It's not the most convincing of touches from Radif either, but it still was good enough to get in the goal. His positioning wasn't good enough for this to stand, nor was his penalty good enough to beat Sarden on. 15 minutes in to this final group game. Two disallowed goals and a save penalty. More of the same, please. Well, actually, let's have some legitimate goals. But you get my point.
Well, having watched the Korea Republic game against Malaysia, I thought maybe the drama was done for today, but this opening quarter of an hour has had plenty. And he's been central to a lot of the drama, Sarunov, with that penalty save on debut. Aldosari. Kardish. Now Mukhtar Ali. Kardish again. Aldosari. Held at bay for now by Supernut.
He's enjoying himself today, this kid, isn't he? He's been a bit subpar in the first two games, a little bit subdued. And
again, that high defensive line could catch Thailand out. Fawaz Al-Yami with a real up and under. Oh, and the goalkeeper, Sarunov, didn't get the greatest distance on the clearing. Punch clear. Back will come the Green Falcons. Mukhtar Ali. Al-Bulehi. Abdulrahman Harib. In towards Abdullah Radif, trying to roll his defender. The Thais trying to remain compact. Mukhtar Ali again. Aldosari. Beautiful balance. Wonderful from Salim Aldosari. It's going to be a corner. But he is such a delight to watch when he's in form.
He's in the mood. He's in the mood to get this one going. I'm not sure if he felt included in that stinging criticism offered by Ludo Mancini. And he took the job just after he'd started, drawing attention to the question marks he had over the commitment of some of the senior players, named a few of them. I wonder if Rossari felt part of it. And now is trying to prove otherwise because he's started on fire here.
Mukhtar Ali's whipped corner into the near post, seen up by Supernat. Harib back for Mukhtar Ali. Yeah. Oh, rangy sort of a switch. I think the final touch came off Faisal Al-Ghabti, but no, corner. To say to the naked eye, it looks as though the Saudi midfielder had put the ball behind, but corner is the verdict. Al-Ghabti himself will take it. Down, Sanat Chuyen, the offender. Al-Ghabti, their post delivery wasn't the best. Nice control by Abdulrahman Harib, but then given away by the Saudis goalkeeper off his line. This is Jerome Sack for Thailand, waiting for the runners. Oh, the gap didn't quite appear for him. And Thailand are denied, but Saudi Arabia were at sixes and sevens defensively from that razor sharp counter from the War Elephants.
Amazing recovery from Fawaz.
Aldosari dispossessed for a moment. Al-Ghabti aware that had a Thai player right at his back. This is Harib. Square for Faisal Al-Ghabti. Al-Yami. Al-Ghabti. Square by Al-Saluli. Abdullah Radif coming to a attack the ball from an offside position.
Well, Tong Tong's been strong since he's conceded that penalty. Only a couple of minutes of the game could have easily rocked him, but he's just used his significant frame to really good effect. He's got a big job on his hands. I mean, I think he's a very, very difficult customer. Welcome signpost to this Saudi team, just how fast these guys are across the road, the pitch.
Sent apart.
Thailand holding on well, playing their own football with enterprise, particularly on the counter-attack. Look really sharp. You've got to be at the top of your game athletically in those breakaways, because the Saudis just run you down. Oh, it's incredible the way he chewed that ground up.
Super nut. For Jaron Sack on the right, it's, he's gone too early. Thai winger. He's just trying to hold the run, isn't he? Didn't quite keep his eye closely enough on the Saudi defensive line. Al-Habari. By Al-Yami, and he's in position for the return ball from Al-Ghamdi. My body for Orn Al-Saluli. Al-Dosri. Saluli again looking for that run in behind, and Al-Yami made it. It had to be a clean intervention. Back come the Saudis. Seen away for now by Jacopa. Saudi Arabia have Abdullah Radif down in the box, injured at the moment. Play will continue for now. If they want treatment for their colleague, they can kick the ball out of play. Not doing so as yet. Now the referee takes matters into his own hands and blows the whistle.
Beautiful play down the right again. Fawaz has really caught the eye in these opening moments. Stretches to bounce the ball back in. Gets the ball first. I think quite clearly that time, Tong Tong. That is a key duel. Both really edging each other. Tong Tong for Thailand and Radhi for Saudi.
Now here's the goal that was ruled out for Thailand. It's no more than a toe, but it's enough.
Well, we did speculate that it was going to be closer than maybe at first looked.
And the one for Saudi Arabia. That's more of
more clear
a
cut.
Foot and ankle.
That's right. That's more clear cut. Which gets to that whole clear and obvious error. Is that tie? Is that clear and obvious when it's that close?
That's the discussion. And you're right in pointing out that pre-game we have the explanation on public address system in all the stadiums about the need for it to be a clear and obvious error. This is karma for Thailand.
I just should say, in defence of the assistant on the far long, far touchline, he gave offside for that one. So that's fair play.
This is Hari. It's a good readjustment from Supanat. Through Supan Tong Song. Now Jacopan. Santipak has lost out to Al-Yami. He's been busy in these early stages down that right flank. It's a loose touch from Abdullah Radif.
I think he's been one of the two players that really made the difference for Saudi. Awaz. Al-Yami. and of course the captain, Salim Al-Dorsari. The two of them have set the stage for the extent to which Saudi Arabia have impressed here, and in possession they've been very impressive.
That ball really was never on for Thailand. There could be a trouble again here. It's Al-Dorsari. It's a stinging drive, which again brings out the best in Sarunov.
And so you look to then the growing influence of Gharib. A little back heel to his skipper, Salem. Oh, just beating that ball away to safety. He's got a fair bit to do to get this game going, but he's done all of it very, very well.
Abdulrahman Gharib with the corner. Players in the back trying to judge when to make their move. Yami's header. Got it back by Al-Ghamdi. All the way back by Abdullah Al-Haibari. Well, but Thailand have pinched the ball through Sarach Yuyan. It's going to be the goalkeepers, though.
It's a little bit wasteful in the end. Two or three occasions now in that midfield. Have stolen the ball beautifully. Really promising counter-attacking opportunities.
He's been on the bench the first two games at this AFC Asian Cup for Thailand, Sarach Yuyan, but leading this new look Thailand team on match day three. Al-Balehi. Dorsari, Mukhtar Ali, and again Yami is in position on the right. Thailand have a man down injured. It is Kritsara Kaman. Yami looking for the give and go with Abdulrahman Gharib. And after that strong start by Thailand, the pattern of the game now seems set handy. Saudi Arabia with the lion's share of possession and the chances, and Thailand playing on the counter.
Yeah, they have dominated possession in all the games they've played. We expect that here again today, although Thailand have been a lot more upbeat than might have expected based on their last outing. Last completion rate is good. Everything's very close together for Saudi Arabia.
Here's Al-Yami.
The long balls, by my reckoning, than most teams in the competition. So very measured and pretty efficient in the attacking half. Creating a lot of shooting opportunities as well. The criticism of them has been of that lack of spark in the penalty area.
Dossery picking up a lot of possession in those little pockets between the defensive lines. They cannot allow him to turn on too many occasions because he will hurt you. Absolutely. Mukhtar Ali. Hugging the touchline is Hassan Kardish. Now a chance for Warachip. Runs straight into trouble. In the shape of Al-Haibari. Gharib. No way through on that occasion for the Saudis. And Santipat for Thailand. Really have too many options. Saudi press has paid dividends.
Yeah, and I think Thailand came the wrong way. As that break was on, they had the option to play to their left side or their right. They opted left.
This is Ali Al-Balehi, winning his 50th cap for his country, by the way, tonight. Saudi number five. Saad Kardish. Reverse ball in behind is Gharib, and near post Abdullah Radif couldn't find the finish.
Growing into the game, Gharib very well defended on the near post by Thailand. He's going into the byline, the cutback's coming to recognise the danger. Chakapan Song closing that angle, making it very tight for Radif. He's again very busy in the this game. A lot of opportunities, half opportunities. Not including the penalty that he didn't convert.
Saudi's on a 7-match unbeaten run at the moment. During that run, they've scored 13 goals, conceded just the one, and that was a penalty at this tournament to Oman, converted by Salah Al-Yahya. Late fight back in that game. Defeat the Omanis by 2-1. And the Saudi fans bringing the noise to Education City Stadium. Their team is well on top, but as yet without rewards. Back heel by Al-Dosri is really the conductor of the orchestra, and somehow he's found a way through that tight gap before eventually Palmer says enough of that. Back to Mukhtar Ali now with Al-Saluli. Harib, Al-Dosri. Working those little triangles, the Green Falcons. Hassan Kardish. Now Mukhtar Ali. Al-Saluli. Thailand are well set defensively on this occasion. Everybody behind the ball, bar Tirasak. Al-Dosri just, again, just peels off that midfield. Back and forth to find possession. Mukhtar Ali, the driving ball across, too far this time for Fawaz Al-Yami, but it's been a good tactic.
Very good. Well defended Thailand. I'd like to see them with qualification secure. As Saudi build and that, and they camp around the penalty area, I'd really like to see Tirasak just drift up to halfway. Use the old parlance, just go and cheat. Just go and sit behind the back foot. Make them look over your shoulder. You've already hurt them a couple of times on the counter-attack. Why don't you play into that? Great speed, actually. I'm not convinced he wouldn't have been able to outrun. And just to compliment my last point, Tirasak actually didn't play any role in winning that ball back. But had he, if he takes a more aggressive position when Saudi are building, just camps on the halfway line, you're either going to draw one of those defenders back to create some more space for a counter-attack, or that first pass can be to you over the top. A lovely ball from Santipap. And if that's confirmed, you have to credit Abadi, who you could see just angle his run forward. He let Borucic break that line, the offside plane. By the looks of things. So refreshing to see Thailand back in this sort of football flow. touchline is doing. The split second decisions. Fabulous.
Dosri. Quite link up with Abdurrahman Harib. Tirasaka's drifted into an offside position, which meant that Jaron Sack could not play him in.
It was devoured by the recovery. Devoured by that recovery from Hassan Hadish. Again, I just want to labour the point. This is the last time I'll say it, but Tirasak's a bit more aggressive than defenders and midfielders carrying the ball. They don't have to take that extra step.
Aldosari, beautiful balance once again. You know, when we talk about the best players from Asia, obviously you're talking about the likes of Son Heung-min. There are a few contenders from Japan as well, but Salem Aldosari is right up there. He is such a player.
Put Musa Altamari from Jordan in that as well. There's no shortage of fabulous players in this confederation.
Just had that very brief spell overseas in Spain. He played once for Villarreal against Real Madrid, no less.
Yeah, as part of that exercise by the Saudi Sports Ministry to take nine designated of their first team, national team players into Spanish clubs in the lead up to the 2018 World Cup in Russia. That was the way they were going to short circuit the issues they thought confronting them and getting their national team up to international standard. It really worked. Next stop is probably a more sustainable one, is to build your domestic league with greater fervour.
Which of course they're doing. Aldosari, little ball pass. And there was Supan Tongsong. Just to put a foot in and save Thailand's blushes for now, but he operates so beautifully in those tight spaces.
Hasn't he been excellent? Tong Song, just in that position, the feet are incredible. From Salah, but Tong Song is on point and ready to intercept.
Corner work shorts, Abdurrahman Harib swings in the cross. Al-Saluli couldn't deflect it goalwards. Haibari to retrieve and get things going again for the Green Falcons. Mukhtar Ali is one of those few Saudis who does have international experience. Had a brief spell, as we mentioned, as a junior with Chelsea in England, where he grew up. And then with Vitesse Arnhem in the Netherlands, where he made a handful of appearances in the Eredivisie. Here he is on the ball. Actually born to Somalian parents. So born in Jeddah. Here's Abdurrahman Harib. Straight down the throats of Serenam.
They're combining nicely though. Harib. Nasri. Make that space. I mean, there's five across the back for Thailand when they're set, and four midfielders sitting in front of them. Space is at a premium.
Thailand have got to stick hold of the ball when they get it. This is Karman. It's beyond Patongpot.
And that's just a little bit rushed. It still presents a great opportunity for Thailand. They're stealing enough possession. It's a huge hole in behind the Saudi attack. When they decide to give and go, the number of players moving forward on the one hand is creditable. You need to get players into the box to finish off these chances. But the interceptions from Thai midfielders, in particular Saraj and Kaman, are then finding a whole pile of space in front of them because the midfield has pushed forward to try and score. You appreciate the aggressive nature of the play.
Well, Saluli with the ball out towards Hassan Kardeş. That was intended, I fancy, for Fawaz Al-Yami. You've had to have been an Olympic sprinter to try and get that.
And the captain looks quizzically. His younger right fullback still looking at him, just waiting for some sort of acknowledgement.
He's a legend in Saudi Arabia, Salem Al-Dosri. Not least, of course, for scoring that winner against Argentina in the World Cup here in Qatar 2022. We weren't able to go on with that, unfortunately. Went out in the group stage. That was intended for Patonpon, but it's not a great ball, fortunately for Thailand.
Yeah, that was a waste.
Jakopan, the offender.
Yeah, and he had plenty of time. But again, they get a rush of blood. They're under a lot of pressure. They're handling it well. And when they get these chances to break out, it's like they get a little bit overexcited. Jakopan, the latest. He'd be accused of that. Very impressive otherwise from Thailand against the heavyweights of the Confederation. Notwithstanding the fact they haven't won this tournament since 1996, it's been quite a dry spell for Saudi Arabia. You can put two or three other heavyweights in that discussion as well, Iran and Korea Republic.
Well, they haven't been past the round of 16 since they reached the final in 2007, where they lost, of course. That's been, as you rightly point out, an uncharacteristic wait for another AFC Asian Cup trophy. About to tick over into first half stoppage time, and there'll probably be a few minutes, not for injuries, but for those VAR reviews.
Yeah, well, we had a couple of them. It's about goals, the penalty review.
And 8 minutes is the verdict. It's Ana Carmen pushed over by Ogandi. Patonpon robbed. A bit of space here for Ogandi. It's an important intervention by Jakopan.
He'd be pretty happy with his team, Ishi-san, don't you reckon? I mean, they've given a great account of themselves here so far.
Well, two goals that were ruled out for offside. On the other end, they've ridden their luck a little bit as well. Radif twice denied, once from the penalty spot, once by the offside flag. It's not going to reach Fawaz Al-Yami, and he's offside as he plays at the ball. He's had a good first half, attacking wing back on the right hand side.
Yeah, I find him very exciting. Potentially nice aggressive arced run. Jeez, that was tight as well.
A three-year absence from the national team, 2019 to 2022. Now very much back in the fold. If you believe the Saudi media reports, about to sign for Al Ittihad in the Saudi Pro League, currently with Al Shabab. Expressed interest in taking him on loan as part of a swap deal. You'd hope his replacement is pretty good for Al Shabab's sake. Here's Patonpon. And now they work the angle nicely. Tirasak. Faced by Orn Al-Saluli. Well defended. Sorry. Santipap's throw. Tompon going to float it in. That glanced off the head of Al-Saluli, so it's going to be a Thailand corner.
They're in no hurry to take it. Get the feeling Thailand will be pretty happy if they can soak up a few minutes on this corner. Close the half out here.
So another very familiar face sat next to Roberto Mancini, that of Yaya Toure, his assistant coach. A one-off. Not exactly getting a friendly welcome in that corner, is he? Sadat Chuyen. Looks like they want to go short, Thailand. They know they don't have too many tall players. Now the cross comes in via the change of angle. Wasn't really a... Oof. I was about to say there wasn't really a whole lot that Supan Tongson could do with that, but it glanced off the post. They're claiming that the goalkeeper actually got a touch here. Raged Najjar, let's have a look. Come off the toe?
He did.
Yeah, he did get
he
a touch.
He punched the ball out. Yeah. Should definitely be in a corner. Not punch, slap the ball out. Should definitely have been a corner.
Al-Dosri. Al-Balehi. Narib. Out for Al-Dosri. Look how much space there is for Fawaz Al-Yami on the right-hand side if they can make the switch. Mokhtar Ali heads in that direction. Al-Khaibari. And Al-Yami's touched down the line for Faisal Al-Ghamdi. It's going to be a corner, although Jacopan is not happy that it is. Again, believing he did not get the final touch, this will tell us. I think he did.
On that angle, it certainly looked like it. Defended these well so far, Thailand. Can they manage one more touch effort?
Abdulrahman Harib to deliver. All central defenders have taken their place in the penalty box. Yeah. Delivery. He's done a few of those this evening. All rather flat.
Yeah, under hit.
Tar Ali, clever ball. Al-Yami. Gets rid of one defender, Abdulrahman Harib, and the flag is up against the Saudi number 18.
Just got a little bit stuck under Fawaz Al-Yami's feet there. Down here nicely. See the one who was called offside? Seems to be.
I think it was Harib.
No, I think it was Al-Yami when the ball first came over. Got his feet a bit stuck, but position and cook the opportunity anyway.
A couple of minutes to go in the first half. We've had plenty of excitement and maybe more to come. It's a good header one by Tirasak. Well, it's an optimistic effort from Waracit. Maybe he felt as though there weren't too many other options.
Yeah, it's
has a little look there, but there's nobody really within range.
One of those overexcited moments.
Ball just about stayed in play. That's a good turn. Abdulrahman Harib. Beyond him is Abdullah Radif. Al-Yami pushing forward down the right. Intervention, a necessary one from Jaron Sack. This is Patompon for Thailand. And it goes off Karman. course, a point would be enough for Saudi Arabia to top Group F. Set up a mouth-watering game against the Korean Republic in the round of 16. They've certainly shown plenty of intent to go out and try and win this game.
Yeah, yeah, I think they're susceptible in transition at the moment.
The prize is a dubious one, Andy, of course.
Yes, of course, indeed.
And that is half-time at the Education City Stadium. No goals, but certainly plenty of action. Three goals rubbed out by either VAR or an offside flag on the field. And also a missed penalty. Abdullah Radif at the centre of the drama. He missed from the spot. Had one ruled out for offside. Thailand have had two ruled out at the other end. And they're also grateful to their debutant goalkeeper, Saranon, for his save of that penalty. Salem Al-Dosri has been outstanding. Plenty for the fans to enjoy, apart from the goals at the break. Saudi Arabia 0, Thailand 0. Welcome back to Education City Stadium, where the light show is in full swing as we await the return of the players for the second half. No goals between Saudi Arabia and Thailand, but certainly plenty of talking points with those three disallowed goals and a missed penalty, or a save penalty, whatever you prefer. If it stays this way, Saudi Arabia will win the group and they will go through to face the Korea Republic in the round of 16. Quite a mouth-watering clash that would be. And Thailand are slated to finish second if it was to end in a draw. They would take on Uzbekistan in the round of 16 as group runners-up. The other game of interest in this section, Oman leading the Kyrgyz Republic by a goal to nil at the break. That would give them a good chance of going through as well, as one of the best third place finishers. Salem Al-Dosri has been a delight to watch again in the first half. His silky skills creating some of the Green Falcons' best moments. Their fans still in pretty buoyant mood, despite the stalemate on the scoreboard. Thailand have certainly played their parts, those two disallowed goals. They haven't scored against the Saudis in 15 years. They haven't beaten them in 40. And they've never won a group stage at the AFC Asian Cup. Let's see if all that's about to change in the second half. No changes that we're aware of made by either coach. Thailand break from their little huddle. Debutant Saranon's had a night to remember, whatever happens. Making the block with the legs from Abdullah Radib's penalty kick. So 45 minutes to go in the group stage here in Qatar. And hopefully Andy Harper, a bit more of the drama that we saw in the first half with the addition of some goals.
We saw some excellent football, another exciting game.
Ali looking to release Fawaz Al-Yami down the right yet again for Saudi Arabia. This is Marco Bardi all the way back to his goalkeeper, Ragit Najjar. Hassan Kardash for Mukhtar Ali. Kardash again. Al-Dosri loves to cut in from the sideline. Salem Al-Dosri. Abdurrahman Darib. Seen out by the excellent Supan Tongsong. He's had a good game at the heart of the back four for Thailand. Alongside Jakobat. Darib. Al-Saluli. Kardash. Ali. Flick with the back of the heel from Abdurrahman Arib. Thailand staying compact. We expect the same sort of pattern to develop in the second half.
Yeah, I think so. Just seeing a slight adjustment for Thailand to start this half. With a five, four across midfield. It looks like they've gone to a back four.
Going to have to defend potentially a long throw here from Kardash. Of course, he makes a fool out of me now by taking it short from Ali. Al-Dosri. Here's the Saudi skipper once more. Teasing Supanan. Playing it back for Mukhtar Ali. Interesting ball from Mukhtar Ali. And you felt that was the only option. As Thailand had defended the space really well. London forward by Supan Tongsong.
Defended the space well, but then weren't sharp enough when they won the ball. They were very good at that in the first half.
still yet to concede in this AFC Asian Cup, the Ties. Given their historical record in this competition, which isn't all that great, quarterfinals on a couple of occasions, it's quite an improvement, especially given Ishii, the coach, has only been in charge a matter of weeks, really.
Yeah, and overlay that, of course, with their historic difficulties against Saudi. Good place at the moment, Thailand.
Stolen the ball back as well, Tirasak. Jakapan. Laid off by Tirasak. Borachit trying to release Jaron Sack through the middle. Saudi had it covered. Al-Dosari. The army calling for it again on the right. They go down the left this time. Hassan Kardish. Plenty of bodies in the middle. Back post was Abdullah Radif. Couldn't get a touch. Reset through Al-Yami. Now with Mukhtar Ali. Al-Yami again. Time to measure the cross. Abdullah Radif got a little piece of it. Still not completely away for Thailand. Al-Dosari. Saudi's pushing and probing. Al-Ghamdi. Kardesh. Al-Ghamdi again. Back through Al-Balehi. Al-Saluli. In their own half of the field. Hassan Kardish finds the space for the cross. Swept away by Jakapan. Borachit can't link up with Tirasak. Back come the Saudis once again. Incessant pressure. Al-Khabari. Al-Dosari. Two defensive lines of Thailand standing resolute, trying to shut down the passing lanes, but it's tiring work. Hassan Kardish, first time ball, and Al-Ghamdi briefly got the better of Supanan. Here he is again. It's good defending by Jaron Sack. They'll look to sweep forward. Tirasak has to hold the ball up and wait for some support, but he's given it away. Al-Ghamdi turns into trouble. Thailand just cannot get out. Al-Dosari runs into Jakapan. There's no foul, and now Thailand can spring forward. Patompot on the left. Al-Khabari, that's really well defended. He showed great pace there to get back.
Well, very good. On notice, because that was the difficulty Thailand presented in the first half, and the first time in the second half, 6 minutes in, that Thailand have actually got the transition working.
Salim Al-Dosari. And it just won't stick for Thailand. Salim Al-Dosari. Good block by Jakapan. Defending increasingly deeper in Thailand. Abdurrahman Ali with a little teasing ball through that defensive line. Now Mukhtar Ali. Ali again. Slows to walking pace. You can almost hear those Saudi minds ticking over, trying to find the space. Where is it? It's not there.
Just overhit slightly. And they're penetrating nicely, Saudi. From an attacking viewpoint, you just get the feeling they're almost there. It's frustrating for their fans. Of course, a lot of pressure then being deflected onto the coach. They don't look that far off. Thailand defending ever so well.
It's just that final ball for the Saudis. Roberto Mancini, of course, has won a continental title already with Italy in Europe. clever and quickly just to shut down the space and force Fawaz Al-Yami back. I'll go down the left instead, the Green Falcons. Al-Dosari out to Hussein Kardeş. Oktar Ali gets rid of Sanat Juyen. They're quickly back in their defensive shape, the War Elephants. Real game of chess going on out there at the moment. Tan Ali turning. Karim drifts past Sanat Juyen. The little wall pass with Al-Dosari. But it's too close to Saranon.
Oh, that's what's missing. And the exchange was beautiful. And he, as we said in the first half, is growing into the encounter. He has that one-on-one ability that can break a pack defence, which he showed then. He couldn't find the pass at the end of it.
Al-Dosari. Talan trying to get back in their shape again. Kardeş, angle ball to the top of the box. Kularadif. And Garib, a dipping shot, which was comfortable in the end for Saranon. Probably not a bad idea to try and mix things up.
Yeah, a little bit, but you know, we've seen repeatedly through the tournament and then said every game of football when a team packs their numbers around the penalty area, it's extraordinarily difficult to get through. And he's shown a way forward, which is close dribbling skills to beat an opponent. On this occasion then he backs himself from distance. To your point, Simon, very worthwhile to draw defenders out and start shooting from distance. You might draw a defender or two out to try and close that down, and then there's space in behind to use. And Thailand will find a bit here, but the ref gets in the way.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Santipap was on the fly down the left-hand side.
Completely accidental, of course. Now Saudi Arabia have got a problem with Hassan Kardeş on this near side. Roberto Mancini in very close attendance to his player. Back of that right knee that's causing the problem. Receiving some attention whilst Mancini just makes some adjustments momentarily. Saudi just down to 10 for the moment, but Tompon, it's a good sliding challenge by Al-Habari. And there's no flag on Abdurrahman Harry. Big chance for Saudi Arabia. Tucks it away. And Saudi Arabia thought they had the leads. They do have the leads. I just thought for a moment the flag had gone up. Oh, that is tight.
Wow.
But I think he's just about, has he managed to stay in his own half?
Well, his toes in his own half, according to that, was his chest and shoulder. It's a great finish. For all intents and purposes, it was a lovely run.
No, it's been given as offside. That's the on-field decision. VAR checking, of course. Are we going to have yet another disallowed goal? The whistles ring out and the boos around Education City Stadium. It's very, very tight. Is his big toe offside? Yep, that's the verdict. Well, that's four now.
Well, this should be one of the easier ones for the semi-automated software. It's right on halfway. Anyway, another disallowed goal, creating some sort of history here in the Education City. Two each now. And a saved penalty.
And that scoreboard remains resolutely blank. Here's Kritsada Karman for Thailand. Supanan. That's a clever little touch from Tirasak. Saraj went down. Thailand continue with the ball. Santipap on the left. Good football this by Thailand. Kutsada Kamen and now Tirasak. And Kutsada, they get it out towards Jaronsak. It's not a bad try.
Worth a go.
Nicely crafted that by the Thais.
Worth a go. Cutting inside to get that curl with his left.
Kutsada Kamen has just stayed down for Thailand. Bit of contact with the defender as he stretched to push it on through for Jaronsak on the right. He's okay to go. Now, here's that previous offside.
Yeah.
There's the defender. Oh, it's a big toe. A big toe.
Well, I actually think it's his chest. His toe's still on the line, according to that. Anyway. Whatever. I have to say to the assistant referee number two on the far side, Park Sang-jun, what a sensational job. What a great set of eyes he's got too. Incredible. He's had three of the four, all incredibly close, and his call vindicated by the available technology. The expertise of our match officials. Do they need technological help, Simon, when they're this good?
Maybe not. Yami. Mukhtar Ali. After that little foray by Thailand, we're back to the familiar pattern of the game. Saudi Arabia pushing and probing. Trying to find space, trying to find the right angle. Nasri is normally able to find the solution. Here he goes. It could break here. Kardish, the cutback. Abdullah Radif, pretty weak effort in the end.
Well, it was off balance. Changes now for Saudi, afoot. You look at how they're attacking here, getting numbers in the box. They're doing so many things well, but Thailand defending it beautifully. Now breaking down the right. Here's a chance.
Jaronsak. That's well defended. Ali Albalehi providing the cover.
1-11, you just don't have time to hesitate or heavy touch. They just across the field so fast. The recovery there from Albalehi was one that matched every other of his teammates.
It's going to be a triple change for the Saudis, but not just yet. They'll wait until this corner is taken. Saku had the shot for the Thais some moments ago, is going to deliver the corner. Thailand are going to make a change of their own. Wiratep is standing by for Masatada Ishii. First, with just under half an hour ago to go, this corner from Jaronsak. And Supanam with a mistake, and it could be on for the counter here, Saudi Arabia. Gharib skips past Santipat. Squares it up. Oh, it's an important touch. Really important touch to deflect it behind for a corner off Sadat Yuyan. Playing a real skipper's role.
What a game he's had, Sadat. So too, Kharib. It's a wonderful break. This is all happening at such speed. Players, no time to react. Got to position themselves. That's great cover there, but beats him with a beautiful touch from Kharib. And it's beautiful, beautiful work. Off balance, but managing to hang on just till that last second, Sadat. To save his team.
Because Al-Ghamdi was arriving. If he doesn't get that touch, you fancy that's 1-0 for Saudi Arabia. Still could be from this corner. Salem Al-Dosri's delivery. Up and out by Jakopan. Now Thailand looking to break. Supanan, he's got to get distance on this. It should bounce through to the keeper. Ragit Najjar. Still those changes on hold for both teams. Into the box goes Abdurrahman Kharib. He got the final touch. It's the Saudi player, And again, Sadac leading by example. Here are those changes for Saudi Arabia. Abdullah Radif, Hassan Kardish, and Faisal Al-Ghamdi are the trio who will make way. And the three new faces, Mohamed Al-Barik, wearing 25, Nasser Al-Dosri, wearing 24, and a young debutant, 16 years of age, Talal Haji, from the Al Ittihad Club. He's only ever played one senior game for his club side, and here he is making his debut at a major tournament.
The youngest.
Youngest ever. At an AFC Asian Cup final.
That's quite the meteoric rise, isn't it?
Yep.
One senior game.
And Wiratek to replace Kuntsada Karman, who picked up that knock some moments ago.
Excellent game. It was showing the signs, however. Come on. The excellent Wiratek take his place. Great swap.
This tells you how young Talal Haji is. He wasn't even alive the last time Saudi Arabia made the AFC Asian Cup final in 2007. To Mancini, giving youth a go, that's for sure. He's in position here, across from Al-Yami, which pops out here for Abdurrahman Garib. And again, Thailand stand their ground and will look to break. Abadi is quick. Too quick for Thailand. ...25 minutes to go. Fascinating contest between these two already qualified teams. Four disallowed goals. Two for either side. And a missed penalty for Saudi Arabia to boot. This is Mukhtar Ali. Al-Balehi. Kebari and Al-Dosri. Touch around the corner from Nasser Al-Dosri. Don't believe they're any relations to Al-Dosri's. This is Patongpon for Thailand. It's not really an outlet for them, but they've worked it well through the midfield. And now Supanan in possession. And Jerome Sack has arced his run well. Can he find the right delivery? Oh, it's too far for Tirasak. It was an inviting invitation. Or situation, I should say, for Thailand.
It's a great bit of space. Just no numbers in the box. Totally confused the whole thought process. Therefore, overhits for the one target he had.
Saudi Arabia, despite their heavy weight of possession and chances, they're not the first team of this AFC Asian Cup to find Thailand a really tough nut to crack. He's got them brilliantly organised, Masatada Ishii.
Well, it took them till deep into stoppage time to get rid of Oman. They found plenty of teams difficult to break, but two-thirds of the field they do very well. Saudi finding that answer in the attacking penalty area.
At the moment, Thailand on track to finish the group with 5 points, which would be their best ever return in Asian Cup finals football. Long way to go, though, yet. It's just got away from Warachit.
The Saudis against the bigger teams, and no disrespect at all to Thailand, because they've been fantastic, but they've not been as clinical in these counter-attacking situations that have developed. And I think it's fair to expect Saudi, whoever the opponent, given the style of play they've got, to attempt to dominate whichever opponent they play, make for great viewing. But against maybe the teams with a little bit more punch in the number 10 position, a striker with just a little bit more help of himself, a little bit more speed. I mean, that's again not to criticise Tirasak. I think they're open for business at times, Saudi. Their challenge is to make sure they can get the goals to stay clear with all the possession they have. The good passing, the interplay between, particularly today, Bossery and Habib.
Here is Salem Al-Dosri. Al-Yami. Salem Al-Dosri again. Use his full name now that his namesake Nasser Al-Dosri is on the pitch as well. This is Mohamed Al-Barek. Not a bad delivery and just nodded over the top by the teenager Talal Haji. Well, that really would have been a story.
Well, he's a big lump for a 16-year-old. Moving either side of the centre half, there he is, just getting blindside, and then into that position, the ball finds him too.
Here's another stat to make you feel old hearts. When, as expected, Saudi Arabia hosts the 2034 World Cup, he'll only be 27.
Well, he must be doing something right. One senior game, thrust into finals match.
Well, to be fair, Saudi Arabia have had a few injuries, as a lot of nations have in the build-up to this AFC Asian Cup. The likes of Fahad Al-Muwallad, Salman Al-Faraj, Yasser Al-Sharani, familiar names across the continent, all ruled out, along with their goalkeeper as well, Mohamed Al-Awais, who's having surgery on a back problem. As Al-Barek nicely floated out to Al-Yami. This is Nasser Al-Dosri. Again, Thailand managed to get bodies in the way. Jakopan. Santipan. The ball in towards Sanachu yet. Supana. Jaron Sak. To keep possession of the ball just about Thailand. Now they'll look to spring forward. Warachit on the move. Had a little glance to look outside. Oh, and Santipat wasn't there. It's a careless giveaway. And they committed numbers forward. Are they about to be made to pay? Abdulrahman Harib on the charge for Saudi Arabia. Harib to tee up. Salem Al-Dosri. Good save, Saranon. Good stretch by the young keeper to deny the Saudi captain.
And indeed, it just adds to the catalogue of really wonderful opportunities. Khalid bursting down the left. The Pompom was chasing. He was putting in the big ones to try and cut off the first pass, which he did. Supernum there as well.
Tirasak giving chase, but it'll be forlornly.
And then that touch just a little bit wide. Salem, nice angle on the shot, not enough power. The excellent Saranon stopping the ball dead in its tracks with that strong fist, strong palm. Put that down as a big escape for Thailand.
Still 1-0 in the other game between the Kyrgyz Republic and Oman, who lead that game. Take Oman onto 4 points. Here's a chance. Oh, inches wide off the boot of Nasser Al-Dosri. They spotted that little gap, Saudi Arabia, and they went for it.
And again, it's Habib. Look at this pass. He threads the needle. The run is a beauty from Nasser. His first touch of meaning off the bench. Maybe a little rushiness there. Across the goal. Here's the breakdown. This is the wonderful bit of the work. Look at the legs pumping. Forces the cutback. The pass is decent. That touch is heavy. The angle is nice, but the power is lacking.
Thailand just repelling raid after raid. Well, they had a touch of good fortune in that last moment. They made a change, by the way, as you're watching that replay. Thailand midfielder Pirodong is on, and also Supachai. There is Supachai to lend a little bit of height to the attack.
Score of two from game one. Should have had a hat-trick in game one. He'd be in the race for the golden boot. We're not so generous to the Kyrgyz Republic that day.
Tirasak has run his race. It's been an enviable task he's had tonight, really. Trying to keep those Saudi Arabian defenders busy. Here is Albreyk. Saudis have had to be patient in both their games so far. Is it going to go their way a third time? Supachai leaving a little bit in on Ali Albalehi, which got him the hard stare.
He does throw the hard stare around him. He's a very impressive footballer.
He's also known as a bit of a wind-up merchant himself,
right,
Ali
yeah.
Albalehi.
Well, in addition to that, you can take it. Nothing shirks away from that truism. Fabulous player. Love watching him play.
He's actually sent off for his club side, Al Hilal, in the big derby against Al Nasser just last month. Had a very solid game alongside Supan Tongsong at the heart of Thai defence. Are they about to keep third consecutive clean sheet? We're into the final quarter of an hour at the Education City Stadium. For all the Saudis huff and puff, yet to blow the Thai house down. No problem with the ball here. Placement call for. And Asatani, she was saying, you come and take it if you want a replacement. I'm under no obligation to give it to you. Floated forward by Al-Kaibani, and Al-Yami is in behind. And there was Santipat.
He's had a huge game. Santipat up against, well, he's been pretty quiet this half, actually. Oh, as Al-Yami, but he was excellent first half. And maybe it's not as much he's been quiet as Saudi haven't directed as much traffic down the right-hand side. Most of the good work, the lock-picking, has been done by Tarib. He's been operating ostensibly down the inside left part of the field in Saudi's attack.
Supachai. Pirodong. Protecting the ball nicely. Patompong. There's a bit more room down the right hand side. Supanan. It's over the head of Supachai.
Slacking quality. It's hurting them. Defending brilliantly. Countering reasonably well. Lacking quality severely in that delivery part of the game, although. Would be unfair not to at that point recall they've had two goals disallowed. Very close things for offside. For all intents and purposes, springing the trap nicely. Just a millimetre out in their execution. Same for Saudi. And then Khadid goal.
Ali lifting the ball over the top for that run of Al-Yami. That's off Jacopan. Another corner.
Behind. Owaz, really. In the corner.
News of a goal for the Kyrgyz Republic against Oman, all square in that game. As it stands, terms of the third place finishes, Indonesia would be in the round of 16 because of that scoreline. Still a way to go yet. Joel Kojo with the equaliser for the Kyrgyz Republic. The change for Saudi Arabia. Mohamed Kano has been summoned to replace the tiring Fawaz Al-Yami. He was very good down that right flank in the first half.
Excellent. This will be a bit of an adjustment too. I mean, Kano's one of my favourites in Asian football. Big man, elegant player.
And it's his 50th cap. Joining Ali Al-Balehi on that mark. Off the bench. Here's the corner. It was wickedly dipped in. Thailand fend the first straight off. And the second. What about the thirds? There's an almighty scramble. Flags up anyway.
Oh, super try. Was superhuman there, saving that first header. The replacement substitute striker for Thailand. He did a fantastic work. Great anticipation to drop off the line and block the route to goal. It's another really good chance for Saudi Arabia.
Well, their fans are maintaining the rage. The players are doing their best, but they just cannot find the solution. Stats that's just come up, Andy, on the screen. Aerial duels one. Sorry, go on.
No, he's going to be offside anyway, but look at that from Superchai, dropping off the line. It's excellent anticipation.
I'm just going to make reference to a stat that just went up on the big screen. Aerial duels one. 8 for Saudi Arabia, but 6 for Thailand. And given that, in terms of physical stature, they're certainly not the tallest team in this competition. It's quite an effort. They've still got more defending to do here. Supanat trying to get a foot in. Forward it goes of Supat Tongsong, but only as far as Mukto Ali. And it goes to the right. This is Albrek. Al-Dosri can't reach it. Abdurrahman Hadi stabs it towards goal, and again there are bodies in the way. Yet more groans of frustration.
Well, it's the pattern of the group stage for Saudi. At their stats as they've accumulated over the first couple of games. They're getting a lot of shots on goal, inside the penalty area shots on goal, but the number of blockages they're forcing, and the defending team on this occasion, the Thais, are just doing brilliantly. They're so alert, they're so alive, Thailand, in their penalty area, and they need to be. They drop off a fraction, and Saudi will get their goal.
Well, we're into the last 10 minutes. Roberto Mancini. Increasingly impatient for the opening goal. Might it come from this set piece? Mercado waiting, but it's angled too close to Superchai, who stayed down, headed the ball perhaps with the wrong parts of the head, and is feeling a little dazed. He's trying to get back to his feet, but he's a bit groggy.
Yeah.
Superchai.
No, he, as soon as he went down, he's got a... How's he feeling there? So this is all right. I mean, this is a topic that hasn't really come up in this tournament yet. No real need for it, from my viewing, but... As soon as he heads that, look, he's got the wobbles. You can't mask that. I don't know that really... There's a clearly enough defined concussion policy in football yet. Bit of water across the face is not exactly the examination a player needs, in my opinion.
Well, they are small in number in the stands, but their team has been mighty on the pitch.
Sure have.
And to be honest, Andy, whatever happens from here on in, the rest of this game, they've had a terrific group stage.
Yeah, well, this has been their most heartening game, I think. I've really enjoyed watching them and the pressure they've been under and the way they've withstood that. Enjoyed watching Saudi as well. Yeah, there's so many good things to their game, with a couple of vulnerabilities. Inability to put opponents away. And that's on it in evidence again here tonight. And just this lingering question I've got about them, defending the mid-third of the pitch when they're going forward. And Korea Republic, if that is to be there, round of 16 opponent will certainly have the weaponry to find some joy in that phase of the game. They don't tighten up. Saudi job here at the moment is to put Thailand away, and they're coming again and again and again, but just cannot find that goal.
Harib has been excellent tonight, sends it back for Al Saluli. There's Santipa to knock it out for yet another corner.
He's been excellent, Santipa.
Here come the artillery from the back for the Saudis. Mohamed Kano at the front there. Behind him, Al Balehi. Al Saluli is in there too. Salem Al-Dosri just lurking at the back of the pack. So it's going to be an in-swinger, perhaps a test again for Saranon. It's a good shape to it. Not sure the goalkeeper got a piece of that, but his defenders helped him out. Back in it comes, Super Chai gets it out. Still pretty much everyone forward for the Saudis. Another cross. This is out Talal Haji, and even Salem Al-Dosri is tiring and can't keep the ball in play. Respite for Thailand.
There's one part of their attack that I'm not that impressed with is the second ball into the box. I think they'd be better off just holding off and resetting. I think they're much more dangerous when they try and move defenders around and thread that pass. They've got no shortage of success in threading the ball through and getting in behind the defence. Challenges inside the penalty area, which have really served them as well. Thailand have outdone them there. The centre too, just quite outstanding. Song and Jakapan, Sandy Papert, left fullback, brilliant.
Here's Nasser Al-Dosri to swing it in. Talal Haji. And there's just no way through. The mass ranks of the Thailand defence do their job. It's an important stretch that by Wiratep, just to hold them at bay for a moment. And it goes to Albrecht on the right. Mohamed Kano, good challenge by Santipat. Now Thailand looks to spring forward. Is that a foul? No. Salem Al-Dosri trying to burst through. It's all a bit disjointed, the play at the moment. Now Patompon on the left. Can't stick hold of it. But a reminder of the historical significance of this. Santipat's down injured at the moment. Thailand are effectively down to 10. Jakapan takes over. It's going to be another corner. But Thailand are within a few minutes of not losing to Saudi Arabia for the first time since 2011. That is 13 meetings ago.
There's another great call from the ref. It's no foul. It's Santipat who's kicked into the legs of the Saudi player. Just not to underscore how much pain it might be in, but I don't think there was any illegality. He hobbles back into his defensive duty.
Al-Shahiri takes the place of Mukhtar Ali. Late change. For Roberto Mancini as he tries to find the answer. Salah Al-Shahiri, another striker. Saranon pushes the ball clear. Not far enough. Is there a push there on the Thai defender? There is. And Thailand can breathe again. Well, you can't blame the two teams for a lack of effort. No. Sometimes goalless draws can be boring affairs, but this has not been that.
Well, it's only goalless because of errant toenails. Let's face it, they've had a few. Or even if the toenails have been clipped before kickoff. No, it's been a really, really good game.
Late double change for Thailand. We're going to see Rungrat on in place of Jaronsak. Also, Chanarong, who's going to make his first appearance at this tournament. Jaronsak in no particular hurry. Two new men sent on, no doubt with very clear instructions. What we have, we hold. It's a good climb by Supercai. Ball still alive. It's going to be a goal kick for Saudi Arabia. We're approaching the final 90 seconds of the 90 minutes. Here goes Salem Aldosari. Outside of it's Nasser Aldosari. It's a good ball in. Oh, good save again, Saranon, to deny the 16-year-old Talal Haji a debut goal for the Green Falcons. He's had a good game, the tie keeper.
An exciting moment for the fans to quite get the power. Talal on the header. Comfortable for the excellent. Otherwise.
Nice little reverse ball from Salem Aldosari to Nasser Aldosari. In fairness, it's a good height for the goalkeeper,
it's
the header.
Very savable. He does well, the youngster. Found space nicely. Just had to retreat slightly to make the contact. Just took the power out of the effort.
Amancano with that flat diagonal switch. Alba Brink has battled for it and won possession. Salem Aldosari, intelligent ball, but it's just got a bit too much on it.
Yeah, just overhit. He's lost his passing range in the second half, actually. Brilliant first half from Salem. Second half, his passing range has deserted him. Very comfortable. What a great game he's had. The goalkeeper for Thailand, Saranon, saved the penalty. The first half, two or three. Good saves, otherwise generally very, very strong. Behind a very strong Thai defence. There's a bit of a mishap. Tiring, it seems to me. Thong Song gave away that penalty at the start of the game. He's recovered manfully to be one of the best for Thailand, but stumbled. Fatigue kicking in as we enter stoppage time.
Of which there's going to be 6 minutes. Thailand that close. They're going unbeaten in the group and finishing in second with a record points haul and keeping three straight clean sheets. But a bit more defending to do yet. Nasser Aldosari with the latest of umpteen corners. Supanan sees it out at the near post. Back with Nasser Aldosari. That should be the goalkeepers. And he won't be in any particular hurry. Saranon.
What if they keep Saudi out? Simon, it's been a huge evening for Southeast Asian football. Malaysia doing the incredible against the Korea Republic, and Thailand so far very nearly at full time holding out against a team against whom over the years they've had no joy.
They are deep into stoppage time in the other game in this group. At the Abdullah Bin Khalifa Stadium, the Kyrgyz Republic won, Oman won.
Which would put the exclamation mark on the Southeast Asian countries. Indonesia getting through to the round of 16.
Maybe going to get better for Thailand. Here we go. Oh, and sliding in. The flag is up anyway. Wouldn't have counted. Play allowed to continue. Chanarong was inches away from applying the finishing touch, but probably would have been ruled out again.
Stop the game. Oh, they might have appreciated that. Now they've got to defend the whole field. They've committed a lot of players forward. Saudi have played out of that. Thailand now take the chance to get reorganised. Saraj moving back into his midfield patrol where he's been just bringing the number six for Thailand.
Here's Nasser Aldosari. Al-Shahidi. Mohamed Kano. Some tired bodies out there. Even though both teams had already qualified, they've left nothing in the tank. That's going to be the goalkeepers again. In 2011, the last time Thailand played against Saudi Arabia and did not lose. That was a goalless draw that time. They've had their chances as well tonight, Thailand. Not too many of them, but a couple of goals ruled out for offsides themselves as well. No way through for Aldosri. Oh, and again, Satipat punches the air as he makes that block. The danger still not quite away. This is Albarek on the right. And the intervention from Jakopan. Chanarov almost sending Alkebari dizzy by turning one way and then the other.
That's a really, really well-won free kick. Superb from Thailand. The collective effort, just superb.
Deep into stoppage time here. Even deeper into stoppage time at the Abdullah bin Khalifa. Still all square between the Kyrgyz Republic and Oman. Indonesia on tenterhooks, waiting to see if their place in the round of 16 is confirmed. As another pass goes astray for the Saudis.
Yeah, from their skipper, as if to underline how much his second half has dropped off. Salem. He's just running the show in the first half defensively for Saudi. Second half, he's drifted to the periphery when he's had possession. Unforced errors have been plenty.
It's too much of a chase, surely, for Albarek. And more valuable seconds tick away. Almost into the last 60 seconds. Quick question for you, Andy, on Thailand in the round of 16. They're going to face Uzbekistan, barring some late miracles. Are there a chance in that game?
Based on today's effort, most certainly they've been outstanding. And Uzbekistan won't be dissimilar an opponent. Very, very good, strong team. You'd have to say probably don't have the speed, 1-11, that the Saudi team can boast. And Thailand have dealt with that well, really well. Yeah, they'd have to fancy themselves to be a chance.
Well, you're not conceding, you're always a chance. And they've almost got the job done here. That's a blatant foul by Wiratep. Maybe one last opportunity for the Saudis. Salem Aldosri. Again, they're driven back out. Mohamed Kano to reset. The excellent Abdurrahman Harib. Thailand have just managed to find bodies in the way every single time. Chanarov leading them a merry dance. Satipat, a tired ball forward. But they have covered every blade of grass.
And Chanarov off the bench has done a great job at the left.
And it's all over. Back-to-back clean sheets for Thailand. In fact, three in a row, back-to-back goalless draws, I should have said. It was a game that had everything but goals. Four of them, two for each side, ruled out by offside flags. A couple of them by no more than a big toenail. We had a missed penalty as well from Abdullah Radif. In the end, Roberto Mancini, Saudi Arabia, are frustrated. They knocked at the door time and time again, but found Thailand in resilient moods, not for the first time in this AFC Asian Cup. And Saranon, one of the heroes, that first half penalty save, a couple more besides. And what a job Masatada Ishii is doing. They go through in second place in the group with 5 points, a record haul in the group stage of the AFC Asian Cup for the War Elephants. Saudi Arabia will win the group though. They go on to face the Korean Republic in the round of 16. What a tie that will be. Thailand move on to face Uzbekistan, and given their performance in the group, you'd have to say they are more than half a chance. Some goalless games, Adal, this one certainly wasn't. Plenty of incident. Abdurrahman Harib was one of the outstanding contributors, but so too was the Thai goalkeeper. And at the end, they could not be separated. Saudi Arabia nil, Thailand nil is the way it finished at Education City Stadium.